What is up? Today, it is January like 17th, something like that. Haven't made an update video in a couple months. I've never made a feeding video. So today, we're gonna be feeding snakes and a whole lot of them. So first we're gonna start out with some kind of smaller stuff. Not too terribly big. Something like this right here, this little pinky mouse. Gonna go right here to this little hog nose. Real gentle eaters. Now these are rear fang venomous. And what he's gonna do is just latch like that and just start chewing. And that's really all he consists of. He's not too hard at all to feed. They're technically venomous. Not anything that'll hurt humans or anything, but super cool pets. Like, super cool. They show affection, which is kind of weird with snakes, because a lot of snakes don't show affection, but I feel like the hognose does. So I would definitely recommend a hognose for a pet snake, if you only have one, and you want an affectionate snake, that'd be one. So up here, we have some African bush vipers. There's the Squamajera right there, and the Chlorhechis is over here. They're both gonna get a pinky, just like what you saw with the hog nose. Let's see, he's usually pretty quick. See if we can sneak up beside him. Sometimes you gotta piss these little dudes off. There he goes. Get him one more again. Get it again. There we go. Now, try to give you a little bit closer of a look. He's always the good eater. This little girl right here though, not so much. Usually, she's pretty hard to make eat. So I'm gonna try that later. I'm gonna get her down later. That way I can have two hands and set y'all up on the tripod and see, kind of show you how I do that. So I'm gonna go ahead and get set up for that now. Here we go. This is the Chlorhechis, the Ophiris Chlorhechis. This is my female little African bush viper. We want to make her bite, and once she bites, just like this right there, boom. See, she's starting to eat on it. Now, look. She is already starting to try to work it down her mouth, but right now she wants to get somewhere safe so she can do it. I'm just gonna keep her safe real quick and let her swallow this. See her using those fangs to really move that pinky mouse down her throat. She's just sitting there walking it down. And that's how venomous snakes eat like this. I really hope it's clear on y'all's picture. Yeah, there she is. And now what she's gonna do, you can kind of still see it. There's a lump in her throat right there. She's just kind of wiggle around, try to move that down to her stomach area. Just try to work it down her body to where it's comfortable again. And right now you're gonna be really fragile with them because you don't want them to regurgitate, because that'll hurt for them. And you don't wanna lose that meal either. just a lot of stress that you don't want these snakes to, or any snake to really go through. So what we're gonna do is put her back up real quick. Whoops, sorry. Okay, so last but not least is the Rhino Viper. On our little guys,
here she is. Now I'm gonna give her one of these guys right here. Looks to be a large mouse. Kind of flake it around like I'm a normal mouse. Maybe touch her a little bit to kind of, oh, there we go. She goes for a long shot. You see how the Bittus species, which is what she is and what the Gabon Viper is, they go for the lungs right there. And they hold their prey above the ground. So if this was alive, it would be dying. And it'd be trying to kick around and get away. It couldn't, because this thing holds it above the ground. And those fangs are just constantly pumping venom into those lungs. And that rat, or whatever this prey item is, in this case it's a mouse, you know, is gonna die pretty quick. So definitely do not mess around with those dudes in West Africa.
Next up is gonna be the Gabon Viper. Mr. Joe Dirt himself, in his new bioactive tank that Davis got us set up on. You can see the plants are doing well. It's a little bit too humid in there, so I'm kind of drying it out. But here he is, West African Gabon Viper. So let's see if he'll go for a long shot for us real quick. He's gonna wait for the perfect shot. Whack, like that, right there. See, he'll also hold it above the ground just like the Rhino Viper. And they'll just let it dangle right there. And what they're trying to do is fill those lungs full of venom and just all those organs and just wait for that venom to kick in and kill that rat. And that rat will not go anywhere if it was alive. And it would just dangle there in the jaws of that snake. Now, those snakes can get pretty big, almost to 5 feet, I think 5 or 6 feet, upwards to 40 pounds. 2.5 inch fangs, the largest venom yield of any snake on the face of the earth, the biggest fangs, like, out of any snake. So just be very, very careful with these guys. They're slugs, but they're still very fast when they strike. They can actually strike backwards, so where my hand is now, quicker than they can do in frontwards. So just remember that. There's not really a safety zone with these snakes unless it's back away from them. So,
that's really it for the Gabon Viper. He eats like a champ.
Let's get that little tail back in there. Come on, bud. And his habitat is gorgeous now also.
Okay. See what that is.
Next up is this crazy buffoon named Bullseye. He's a 2-year-old Michael Cobra. One of my favorite snakes I own. He's a little crazy though. Look, and there he goes. Come here. Get back in there.
Okay.
Told you. He's a little crazy. There you go. Come here. Come here. There you go. About time, dude. Like he's all mad. What he's gonna do is probably take that and then take it into his little cave over there. So that way nobody can try to steal his little food. They can get pretty aggressive towards their food, because as you can tell, they really like it. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn this light off. But yeah, they're cool. Just really know what you're doing before you get one. Next up on the feeding list is gonna be Caroline. She's getting a probably like a medium-sized rat, I would say. Let me move this just a little bit. I'd say a medium-sized rat. She is getting really thick because she is gravid. So I'm just gonna politely ask if she wants some of this. You want some of it? Ooh, she did want some of that. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna make it run. Oh my gosh, oh goodness. I'm just gonna put it up here because there's less sand up there. She'll still find it, but yeah, man. Let's take a closer look at what we're dealing with here. That is Caroline, the prairie rattlesnake. She is probably gonna drop babies here pretty freaking soon. So I'll keep you up to date on that. I separated all the other rattlesnakes that lived with her a couple weeks ago. So hopefully, just hopefully, we'll have babies pretty soon. Oh, look at the python. I don't know if you can really see them, but they can smell that the rats are thawing out. So they know that something is happening. But next up on the list, we're gonna have Bojangles, the Eastern Diamondback Rattlesnake. So I'll get this camera set up and everything like that, and we will just cut to it. All right, like I said, Bojangles is next. He's the 2 year old Eastern Diamondback. I think he's a little bit older than 2 years old, but I don't have a screen lid for him, so I gotta put y'all on the tripod. We're gonna see how fast he takes this. I've got him on a slightly larger rat than usual, just to see how he deals with it, because I think he could easily take it. But we shall see. See now he smells it. You see those tongue flicks, and now he's looking at it. He knows something's there, and now he's curious. Now he's just gonna check it out, make sure that he thinks it's a rat. You're gonna make sure it's a rat before he strikes. Ooh, there we go. And that's all it really takes for him. Just one hit, he'll go back and eat it later. Naturally, they don't eat it right off the bat because they gotta go let it die somewhere. And so the rat will get hit, it'll crawl, it'll go either there, or it'll crawl over there somewhere and burrow and, you know, because it just got bit by a freaking rattlesnake, so it's not the happiest thing. But look at that little dude. He's very proud of his meals. And I'm not going to be one to take it from him. So we're going to leave him in there with that, same as the other rattlesnake. They'll kind of find where they are. They'll sniff it out, and they'll start eating it, like Caroline's already starting over here. See, she hit that rat a little bit earlier, and now she's already looking for it. She doesn't really wait for it to die, because she always gets frozen thawed. She's pretty smart. But she'll go over there and start on that. But here's Thomas. Everybody meet Thomas. He's my cousin from a different
family.
Yeah, that. And Thomas is helping out today with some filming and snake stuff, learning some ropes and everything. So I guess next now is gonna be the new cobra, the bigger guy. And I've never fed him before. I've not had him for that long. I got him kind of out of a bad situation. The guy didn't want him, and he rescued it from another guy. And so they were both kind of scared of him, but this right here is about a 4 foot monocle cobra, male. He's really mean. If anybody wants a 4 foot male monocle cobra, let me know, because as you can see, I don't trust him in anything else other than this. And this is way too small for him. So you can see why. Look at that monocle though. He's really pretty. But yeah, next up is him on the feeding list. So we'll go ahead and get the tripod set up and get back to it. All right, so this cobra is pretty freaking dangerous. He's not the nicest thing ever. He's really cage aggressive, just like my other monocle cobra. I think it's just the way monocles are. But what I'm gonna do is go ahead and unlock it. I'm gonna take the key out so it doesn't fall. Put pressure on the glass. See, that way, if it would've fell, he could've got my hand. So now I'm gonna back up and let it kind of close like this right here. And there he is in all his precious glory, Jafar.
anybody wants to farm that is experienced enough to keep it, let me know. Well, we're going to see how Jafar does with his first rat in the house. All right, that was a pretty terrible miss. That was it. Woo, there he goes. Come on, bud. He really left. He hit that rat one good time, but now he's trying to leave. So what I'm going to do is probably just lay it out for him. I want him to hit it one more good time so I can really... Yep, see? See how he has his mouth open and gaping like that? He is pissed off. Now it's something... Woo! You do not want to get bit by this dude. This is a little bit worse than a king cobra. This is a monocle cobra. They have a Naha toxin. Let's make some sure cobras. 30 minutes or less, you need to be at the hospital or you're probably not going to make it. These things kill over, not things, but these snakes kill 40,000 people year round globally. So we're just going to leave that in here for him. Woo! See? Very, very dangerous snake. I'm going to put the tab down. See, I still have pressure right here. You always want pressure on this. Because, you know, if he hits it and it falls, you could have a really bad day. Now, there's that. We will leave that in there for him. He will sniff it out with his tongue, just like every other snake. Big snake. It's a big cobra. Big monster.
Shoot poison all over the glass?
That's, yeah, that's venom. That's venom. But yeah, he's a little feisty.
I'm trying to defend myself.
Thomas has some tongs for safety. But yeah, he's a great, like, great hooder, though. If anybody does, you're looking for, like, a really good hooder that always hoods up at you, that's one. So, hit me up. We're going to keep feeding a little bit more snakes. But other than that, it's almost done with the snakes, I think. So, I don't know. I'll recheck everything and recount, but stay tuned. This is Psycho, the melanistic western diamondback. I call him Psycho because he's freaking psycho. That was a pretty hard hit, Psycho, but we're going to go ahead and leave that right there on you. He's absolutely gorgeous snake, but he is completely nerve-wracking to work with. Let's see if I can get you a better look. You see that? Before you even know it, it's already done and over with. See, I'm standing up right there. He's saying, don't mess with me. Especially now that he's got food. He's pretty pissed off. But yeah, that is Psycho, the melanistic western diamondback rattlesnake. Okay, so we're done feeding snakes. They're all fed. Well, mostly all of them. Everybody that's going to eat today is all fed. But before I go, I wanted to show y'all guys a new animal. Picked him up the other day. He hadn't really eaten for me. And he bit me pretty decently, but he hadn't bit me since. So without further ado, here is our new Cuber's caiman, our dwarf caiman. He's gorgeous, though. I'm going to lose a finger to this guy, probably, but at least he'll look good doing it. That is so cool. I love this little dude. I've always been obsessed with crocodilians like this. And now that I get to own some like this, it's freaking awesome. I love the support and all the tips and the helpful tricks. Like and subscribe for more. Just let me know what y'all guys wanna see. If you wanna see more crocodilian content or more snake content, non-venomous, venomous, doesn't matter. Just let me know what you think. And always don't be scared to DM me or get in touch with me. Let me know if you see anything that I could be doing better. Let me know. It's always a learning game. You guys have kept it pretty straightforward. So, I can't thank you enough. As always, this is Braden. Braden Allen's Reptiles. We will see you next time.